going to deal with the slowdown. Time to respond to people's longest work and more to discuss changes in policy matters for the coming year. The National People's Congress is set to open for in Beijing. The quarter's vehicles are undergoing rigorous security checks. Police are providing tighter security. The Congress is an important event that has great bearing on the nation's prestige. One day before its opening, an announcement was made today by Hu Yun, spokesperson for the National People's Congress annual session. He says China's military spending is budgeted to grow by around 7 to 8% in 2016, which is lower than any recent year. Growth in military spending is below 10% for the first time in 6 years. This is apparently a reflection of the slowdown in the Chinese economy. Hu says the Chinese economy is under stronger pressure. Downward pressure, she says the economy is facing new challenges. The economy is sluggish. This phenomenon is seen everywhere in the country. Instructed by the local government, the cement factory was blasted with dynamite. This is the outskirts of Xinjiang Province's Hebei province. Cement production has long supported the local economy. But demand for cement is declining these days. The town's economy has become sluggish as many cement factories have gone broke. This resident says most workers who came to this area to work have moved to other places. Behind the situation is an oversupply in the real estate market. Houses were supposed to have been built on this land, but the start of construction is nowhere in sight. The area measures more than 700 million square meters, which is larger than the total country worth of money.
Our reporter Tomoki Matsuda came across something surprising in one housing district in the southern region of Guangxishuang. Luxury condominium buildings line the streets, but the site changes dramatically after nightfall. Shortly after 7 p.m., but no lights are seen from any of the windows in the buildings. Many condo buildings have been built over the past several years, but many of them remain unsold. The district is considered one of the most serious ghost towns in China. What should the government do with such huge property inventories? The leaders of President Xi Jinping's administration now focuses on migrant workers from rural areas. The government is trying to reduce the excessive number of empty properties by having those workers settle in cities. There are about 270 million such workers in the country. This official says, let's carry out the key national policies for selling houses that still haven't been sold. This housing fair was held by the regional government of Hsinchu to attract seasonal workers who returned to their communities during the Lunar New Year holiday. About 40 realtors took part in the fair and competed against each other for business. Some of them even put up shut down saying that the workers on the need to provide money or cash payment, but they become eligible for a cash discount of 30,000 yuan. Other ads guarantee no down payment, zero interest, and no tax. All kinds of tax rates